Now to another in our brief but spectacular series where we ask interesting people to describe their passions. Tonight we hear from artist Io Tillett Wright, whose photography projects have sparked a dialogue on gender identification and sexuality. Io's memoir, Darling Days, was released this week by Echo.
My earliest memory of wanting to be a boy was when I was had my fifth birthday party, and I had this lacy blue dress. And the second I got home, I was just like, get this thing off of me, and I ripped it off, and I like put on warrior paint, and I went up to the roof, and I like took a piss standing up. That was my like ownership of it. These kids were like, are you a boy or a girl? And I was like, why does that matter? I can play better than you. And they didn't let me play. And I went to my dad and I was like, hey, I'm a boy now. And he was like, okay. My mom's attitude was, yeah, as long as you can get acting roles as a boy, I don't care. My mom put me into child acting. I only played boys until I was 17. And then I played a couple girls. And that's when people started to tell me that I was too unique. And I was like, if one more person tells me I'm too unique, out of here. And I did. I quit. I miss acting. But do you cast me as a boy? Do you cast me as a girl? Do you cast me as the gay girl? Do you cast me as the trans kid? Oh.
You've got incredible range.
I've got incredible range. For the last 6 years, I've done this project where I've been photographing 10,000 people who identify as anywhere on the LGBT spectrum in all 50 states. If you look into the eyes of a person that you discriminate against, or you think is so different than you that they deserve less rights than you, it becomes almost impossible to deny their humanity. The complicated part of that is, I'm not trying to say we are all the same. What I'm trying to say is we are all completely different, and that's the beauty of it. I'd set out to photograph gay people and trans people, and what I'd found was that people from older generations identified super strongly with labels because they'd had to fight for them. But younger people were more like, well, yeah, I loved a guy and now I love a girl, and maybe I'm a more boyish tomorrow. They're more fluid on a spectrum of things. I think the most dignified gift you can give them as a human, as part of their family or their family of friends, is the right to change. I'm Io Tillett Wright, and this is my brief but spectacular take on expanding one's circle of normalcy.
You can watch additional brief but spectacular episodes at pbs.org/newshour/brief.